the students of IIYS school. This is your maths teacher. So now let's start the class. This is your class 7 maths. And let's start the class by sharing some general instructions. Don't raise hand during lecture. Ask question at the end of the lecture. Use hand free if you are using mobile and headphones for computer use. Feed your ID and password properly with your name and class. Take care of time for attending the class. Home task should be done in your fair copy of the subject. If there is any disconnectivity during the lecture, try to join again within 5 to 10 minutes. Now, this is chapter number 5. In this class, we will continue chapter number 5. In previous class, we have also discussed chapter number 5. So, that was the lesson number 1. And today, chapter number 5, lesson number 2. And the name of the chapter is Fraction. It is compulsory to use all the students to take your books and copies with you. So now, objectives or topics of today's class are, in today's class, we will learn addition and subtraction of common fraction, product of fraction by a whole number, product of two fractions. So these are the topics of today's class. Now, first up today, now we'll start the class first. From the first objective, that is addition and subtraction of the common fraction. Addition and subtraction of the common fraction. So first rule is, before you can add or subtract fractions, before you can add or subtract fraction with different denominators, you must first find equivalent fraction with the same denominator like this. Means when you are adding or subtracting the fraction which have different denominator, so what you will do, you will first find the equivalent fraction. Means it is compulsory to add or subtract the same fraction. Before, if the fractions are different, so first you will find the equivalent fraction. So before you can add or subtract fractions with the different denominators, means when the two fractions having the different denominators and you have to add or subtract them, so first what you will do, you will find the equivalent fraction, means with the same denominator. Now let me share some example. Find the smallest multiple LCM of both number. So if we are just considering two fraction having the different denominator, so first what we will do, from denominator of the both fraction, you will find out the LCM. So first you will find out the LCM of both number. Then you will rewrite the fractions as equivalent fraction with the LCM as the denominator. Now what you will do, you will rewrite the fraction as equivalent fractions with the LCM as the denominator. Example, if like fraction means they are having the same denominator. If the two fractions, the task is to add the two fraction which are like, means they both are having the same denominator, so it's easy to add them because we'll just write 7. When you add or subtract, you just add or subtract in the numerator, and in denominator you will just write the number as it is. So here the denominator is 7, so as it is we write 7 over here, and we just add the numerators 4 plus 1 is 5, so this become 5/7. So when you will add 1/7 plus 4/7, you will get 5/7, because this is like fraction, because denominators are like, so you will just write the denominator as it is. Now for the subtraction, this is 4/5 and this is minus 1/5, and the task is to subtract them. So as you can see that here the denominators are same. So in the answer, we will just write 5 as it is, and in numerator, we will subtract 4 minus 1. 4 minus 1, you will get 3. So it's become 3/5. Okay, students, you get it. This is the example of like fraction. It is very easy to solve like fractions because in just like fraction, you will just rewrite the denominators as it is. And you will just do the simplification in the numerator. Now, let us consider the example of unlike fractions. So, the unlike fraction, first consider 1 upon 2 plus 2 upon 3. This is example, first example of unlike fraction, and the example is 1 upon 2 plus 2 upon 3. So, what you will do, you will rewrite the question over here, 1 upon 2 and 2 upon 3. And then, first you will find out the LCM of 2 and 3. First, you'll have to find out the LCM of both the denominator. They are unlike fraction, means both the fraction are having the different denominator. Here is 2 and here is 3. So the first step is to find out the LCM of both the number 2 and 3. So the LCM of 2 and 3 is 6. The LCM of 2 and 3 is 6. So now what you will do, you will write the multiple of 2 by which you can get 6. 2 ka table aap itna padhenge, you will get 6. So 2 threes are 6, same as 3 ka table aap itna padhenge, you will get the LCM, that is 6. So 3 twos are 6. So it become 2 threes are 6 and 3 twos are 6. And remember, 6 is our LCM. 6 is the LCM of this unlike fraction. Now, whatever you write in the denominator, you will write as it is in the numerator, because this is the equivalent fraction. Same as whatever you are writing in the denominator, you will just write in the numerator. Now, this becomes 6. 2 3s are 6, 3 2s are 6, 6, 6, and 3 1s are 3, and plus 2 2s are 4. So now this become like. This become like fraction. Now you just write the denominator once, that is 6, and 4 plus 3 is 7. Because 7 upon 6, this is improper fraction. So as per rule, you will convert the improper fraction into mixed number. So you will divide 7 by 6. So this becomes 6 ones are 6 and plus 1, 7 upon 6. This is improper fraction, and in the solution, you can't answer in the improper fraction. You'll have to convert that into mixed number. So this is the example of like fraction. This is the example of unlike fraction. Like fractions are very easy or simpler to solve, in just that you will just rewrite the denominator as it is. जब आप like fractions को solve करते हैं, तो आप denominators as it is write up कर देते हैं, और numerator में आप plus और minus करते हैं. But when you are solving the unlike fractions, so first you'll have to make the denominator like. आप unlike fraction solve करते वक्त denominator को same बनाते हैं, first by taking LCM. आप पहले LCM लेंगे, 2 और 3 का LCM is 6. Okay, so फिर आप denominator में 6 लाएंगे, जो आपका LCM आया है, by multiplying. 2 का table इतना पढ़ेंगे, you will get 6. So 2 3s are 6, same as 3 का table इतना पढ़ेंगे, you will get 6. So 3 2s are 6. So whatever you write in the denominator, write in the numerator as it is. Whatever you write in the denominator to make it 6, the same repeat in the numerator, and then just multiply. 3 1s are 3 and 2 3s are 6, 2 2s are 4 and 3 2s are 6. In this way, you can get the like fractions. Now you just add them. 4 plus 3 is 7, and write the denominator as it is, that is 6. And this is the improper fraction, because numerator is greater than the denominator. So at the end, you will convert it into mixed number. So this is the way to answer that. Okay, hope student, you will get this, both the solution. Now move forward towards the next slide. That is exercise 5.1. Now open exercise 5.1 in your books also. Open exercise 5.1 in your books also. This is question number 3. That is find the value of. And this is part number 2. Question number, exercise 5.1. Question number 3, and it's part 2. That is, you'll have to find out 3 upon 4 plus 1 upon 4. Now, when you can see the question, you can easily observe or easily identify that the given question is like fraction. The given question is belongs to the like fraction. I have mentioned over here that these both the fractions are like fraction because both the fraction are having the same denominator. So it is very simpler to solve this question. So what you will do, 4, 4, just write as it is 4. In denominator, just write 4 and in numerator, add 3 plus 1. 3 plus 1 is 4, 4 upon 4. Now cancel this, 4 ones are 4, 4 ones are 4, you will get 1. So this is very simple question, very easy question, because this belongs to the like fraction. In this, you just have to work some, do some simplification in the numerator. 3 plus 1 is 4 and already we are having 4 in the denominator. So you will get 4 upon 4. After cancellation, you will get 1. Now move towards the next question. This also belongs to exercise 5.1, but this is question number 3, part 11. This is part 11. Mark this question also in your books, part 11. Okay, now this question is of unlike fractions. 11 upon 12 minus 5 upon 6. This is question number 3. Part 11. Mark this question in your book also. Now, what you can see first, you can see easily that both the denominators are not same. So you can identify that the given question is unlike fractions. So what you will do when denominator are different, first we will take the LCM. So first what you will do, you will take the LCM of 12 and 6. So 2 6 are 12, 2 3 are 6. Okay, the multiple of 12 and 6 will be 2. 2 6 are 12 and 2 3 are 6. So 2 3 are 6 and write 3 as it is. Now 3 1s are 3 and 3 1s are 3. Now multiply these three numbers. 2 2s are 4, 4 3s are 12. So the LCM of 12 and 6 is 12. The LCM of the 12 and 6 is 12. Now what you will do, you'll have to make the denominator 12 of both the fraction. Okay, so 12 ones are 12 because this is also 12. There is no need to change anything. 12 ones are 12. Now this is 6. You'll have to convert this 6 into 12. 6 into 12 by multiplying. So 6 ones are 6. 6 twos are 12. 6 twos are 12. So multiply by 2. So you will write multiply by 2 in the numerator here, and we will write multiply by 1 over here because this is already 12. So 12 ones are 12, so we will write multiply by 1 over here and multiply by 2 over here. So this become 12. 11 ones are 11 minus 5 twos are 10. So in next step, 11 ones are 11 minus 5 twos are 10. 11 minus 10 upon 12. This 12 is our LCM, and we'll also convert this 6 into 12 already. Now 11 minus 10 is 1. 1 upon 12. Now this is the given fraction is proper fraction, so there is no need to convert this into mixed number. So you can just answer in this way. Hope you'll get the solution, or may I repeat? The thing is that जब हमें अनलाइक फ्रैक्शंस दिए जाते हैं जिसमें डिनोमिनेटर डिफरेंट होते हैं, तो पहले हम एलसीएम लेते हैं. 12 एंड 6 का एलसीएम इज 12. फिर आप डिनोमिनेटर में इस नंबर से मल्टीप्लाई करें कि आपके पास दोनों में 12 आ जाए. दिस इज 12. सो वी जस्ट मल्टीप्लाई 12 वंस आर 12. एंड वट एवर द नंबर यू विल मल्टीप्लाई इन द डिनोमिनेटर, यू विल मल्टीप्लाई इन द न्यूमिनेटर ऑल्सो. नाउ दिस इज 6. 6, you will convert 6, you have to convert 6 into 12. Aapko 6 made 6 ko 12 mein convert karna by multiplying. So 6 twos are 12. So whatever you do in the denominator, you'll have to repeat the process in the numerator. So multiply by 2 and multiply by 2. So multiply by 1 over here and multiply by 2 over here. Just multiply and just solve it further to get the answer. Hope students you will get the solution. Now move towards the next question. This is question number 4, part 12. Question number 4, part 12. And the question is 2 whole. This is whole. Means the question is given in the form of mixed number. 2 whole 5 upon 77 minus 1 whole 2 upon 55 minus 1 upon 35. Okay, so first what you will do, you will convert all the mixed fractions into improper fraction. You can't simplify the mixed fraction. हम मिक्स फ्रैक्शंस को सिंप्लीफाई नहीं कर सकते. फर्स्ट विल हैव टू कन्वर्ट द मिक्स फ्रैक्शंस इनटू इम्प्रॉपर फ्रैक्शन. एंड हाउ यू विल कन्वर्ट दिस, यू विल मल्टीप्लाई द होल नंबर विद द डिनोमिनेटर एंड देन यू विल ऐड द न्यूमरेटर. सो 2 × 77, फर्स्ट यू विल मल्टीप्लाई दीज टू नंबर. फर्स्ट यू विल मल्टीप्लाई 77 बाई 2 एंड देन यू विल ऐड 5 इन इट. सो यू विल गेट 159. This become 159 upon 77 and this is 55. 55 ones are 55 plus 2 is 57. 57 upon 55. Now this is 1 upon 35. This is proper fraction, so there is no need to convert. You just convert the mixed number into improper fraction. Okay, and now just solve it further. As you can see that all the denominators are different here. 77, 55, 35. So what you will do first, you will find out the LCM of 77, 55 and 35. Okay. Now, 5. First you will take 5. So 77 is can't be factorized with 5. So just write 77 as it is. 5 11s are 55 and 5 7s are 35. In next step, write 7 as a multiple. So 7 11s are 77, 11 as it is, and 7 1s are 7. Now you just see two 11s over here. So 11 1s are 11, 11 1s are 11. Now the multiples are 5, 7, and 11. Multiply 5 with 7, 5 7s are 35, and 35 11s are 385. So here the LCM is 385. So what you will do, you'll have to make all the denominator 385. 77 ko aap ek kis number se multiply karein, then we will get 385. Same aapko identify karna hai, 55 ko aap kis number se multiply karenge ki aapke paas aapka LCM aaja, that is 385. Same as you will multiply 35 with the number, that you will get 385. Okay, so when you will multiply 77 with the 5, you will get 385. Multiply in your calculators or in your rough copies, multiply 77 with 5, check, you will get 385. Same as when you will multiply 55 with the 7, you will get 385. Same as when you multiply 35 with 11, you will get 385. So after multiplication by this number, you can get all the denominators 385. So 385, 385, 385. So jis bhi number se aapne denominator mein multiply karwaya, same aap usko numerator mein as it is multiply karwayenge. So 159 into 5 minus 57 into 7 minus 1 into 11. These are the number by which we can make the denominator 385 as per our LCM. ये वो नंबर है जिससे हमने अपने डिनोमिनेटर को 385 बनाया है, जो कि हमारा LCM है. So now multiply 159 with 5, you will get 795. Minus when you will multiply 57 into 7, you can get 399 and minus 11 ones are 11. Now solve it further upon 385. 385 is our LCM. Now when you will multiply 795 minus 399, multiply in your rough copy, check it students. When you will subtract 795 by 399, you will get 396. When you will subtract 399 from 795, you will get 396 minus 11. Now when you subtract 11 from 396, you will get 385, and in the denominator we are having 385. Both are same, 385 385. You can cancel both of them and then answer will be 1. Hope you will get the solution students. Any confusion? Okay, now move towards the next slide. This is question number 4, part 6. question number 4, part 6. Mark this question also in your book. Exercise 5.1, question number 4, part 6. And the question is simplify. Here the instruction is simplify. Mark this question in your book also. Part 6 is 1 upon 3 plus 3 upon 4 minus 5 upon 12. Now you here, you can see both the operation plus and minus. You can see both the operation, and you can also notice that all the fractions are unlike fraction because denominators are different. Denominator are different. Okay, the easy way to solve this question, you can solve three fractions together, all three fractions together, but there is a way that you can just solve first two fractions, then you can subtract. It's up to you, but in this I'm sharing the simpler version, that is you can simplify all three fractions together by taking the LCM of 3, 4, 12. This is the simpler version that you can solve all three fractions together. If numerator are same, for example, this is 3, 3, 3. So you will just write 3 in the denominator and just simplify the numerators. If the denominator is same, you will just write the denominator as it is and just simplify the numerator. If the numerator is same, so simplify accordingly. Now, in this question, we will take the LCM of 3, 4 and 12, and the LCM will be, you'll get 12 as a LCM, and you will take the LCM of 3, 4 and 12. This is the process, and after taking the LCM, you will get 12. The LCM of 3, 4 and 12 is 2, 3. The LCM of 3, 4 and 12 is 12. Now, what you will do? 3, you will convert this 3 into 12 by multiplication. You will convert this 4 into 12 by multiplication. Also, you will convert this 12 into 12. So 12 ones are 12. 4 threes are 12. 3 fours are 12. So these are the number that are written in green here. Jo number green se likhe hain, unko humne multiply karwaya hai denominators ko 12 banane ke liye, jo ki hamara LCM hai. तो जिस नंबर से हमने डिनोमिनेटर को मल्टीप्लाई करवाया है 12 बनाने के लिए, सेम हम उनको न्यूमरेटर में मल्टीप्लाई करेंगे. सो 1 4 जा 4 प्लस 3 3 जा 9, 5 1 जा 5. सो 4 प्लस 9, व्हेन यू विल ऐड 4 प्लस 9 यू विल गेट 13 माइनस 5 एंड अपॉन 12. दिस 12 इज आवर LCM. Okay, now subtract 13 minus 5 upon 12. When you will subtract 13 minus 5, you will get 8 upon 12. 8 upon 12. So 8 upon 12. What you will do next? Cancel this. Cancel this 8 and 12. So 4 2s are 8. 4 3s are 12. This is 2 upon 3. So the answer is 2 upon 3. So this is proper fraction. There is no need to convert this proper fraction. If the numerator will be same, just solve accordingly. It depends on the numerator that either you will take LCM or not. Numerator same होने से कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ता, but denominator same or different होने से हम process decide करते हैं कि either we'll take LCM or we don't take LCM. In numerator, just solve, if this is 1 upon 3 plus 1 minus 5, just solve accordingly. Answer will be 12. Now move towards the next question. Now move towards the next question. Product of a fraction by a whole number. This is product. What is product? The answer of multiplication is called the product. So product of a fraction by a whole number. To multiply a whole number with a proper or an improper fraction, we multiply the whole number with the numerator of the fraction, keeping the denominator same. Product of a fraction by a whole number is that, कि जब आप multiply करवा रहे हैं किसी भी fraction को by a whole number, product is answer of multiplication is called the product. So to multiply a whole number with a proper or an improper fraction, we multiply the number with the numerator of the fraction, keeping the denominator same. हम किसी भी नंबर को मल्टीप्लाई कराएंगे तो हम सिर्फ न्यूमरेटर से मल्टीप्लाई करेंगे, जस्ट कीपिंग द डिनोमिनेटर सेम. देयर विल बी नो इफेक्ट ऑन द डिनोमिनेटर. तो दिस इज द एग्जांपल दैट इज 5/12 व्हेन मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 24. सो दिस इज योर बुक एग्जांपल. 5/12 मींस दिस इज द फ्रैक्शन एंड यू विल मल्टीप्लाइंग, यू आर मल्टीप्लाइंग द फ्रैक्शन विद 24, दैट इज अ होल नंबर. सो व्हाट यू विल डू, यू विल जस्ट मल्टीप्लाई द 24 विद द नंबर 5, दैट इज द न्यूमरेटर ऑफ द फ्रैक्शन. देर इज नो चेंज ऑन द डिनोमिनेटर, यू विल जस्ट मल्टीप्लाई द होल नंबर विद द न्यूमरेटर. So 5/12 when multiplied by 24, what you will do, you will multiply by 5 into 24, keeping the denominator same. So we'll just write upon 12. There is no change in the denominator, just write upon 12. Now there is two ways to solve this. First you will multiply 5 into 24 and then divide by 12. And the simpler way, these both number are multiplying 5 into 24 and the both number are dividing by 12. So if there is any cancellation possible between the numerator and denominator, so do it over here. Agar koi bhi cancellation yahan pe numerator or denominator mein possible hai, so do it over here to simplify it. So 12 ones are 12, 12 twos are 24. This is a simpler way. Just cancel over here. 12 ones are 12. 12 twos are 24. Now in next, what you will do? 5 twos are, you'll just remaining is 5 twos are upon 1. 5 twos are 10 upon 1. In upon, we can't write. We don't write 1 in the upon, 1 in the denominator. We don't write 1 in the denominator. So this is the example of product of a fraction by a whole number. And the rule is that the whole number, when you are multiplying whole number with the fraction, you will just multiply in the numerator, keeping the denominator same. Okay, students, hope you'll get this. Now move towards the next slide. Product of two fractions. Product of two fractions. Product of two fractions. Product of their numerators. Product of their denominators. Product of their numerator upon product of their denominator. Product, same as previous, I have told you in previous slide that product means the answer of multiplication is called product. When you are multiplying two fractions, means both are fractions, when you there is no whole number over here, both the numbers are the fractions here. So what you will do, you will multiply both the numerator together and both the denominators together. Now let's consider the example. Example number 2, 8/9 multiplied by 9/16. So now this is related to this example, related to this topic, product of two fraction. 8/9 is a fraction and 9/16 is a fraction. So 8/9 and 9/16. So what you will do, multiply both the numerators together and multiply both the denominators together. So 8/9 multiply by 9/16. So 8/9/16. The simpler way, if there is any cancellation possible, do it over here. There is no need to multiply and then cancel. Another way is कि आप मल्टीप्लाई करा लें फिर आप कैंसिल करें. बट द सिंपलर वे इज के इफ देयर इज एनी कैंसिलेशन पॉसिबल, डू इट ओवर हियर. सो 8 ones are 8, 8 twos are 16, 9 ones are 9, 9 ones are 9. द कैंसिलेशन इज डन. नाउ जस्ट मल्टीप्लाई, 1 multiplied by 1 upon 1 multiplied by 2. सो 1 ones are 1 and 2 ones are 2. सो द आंसर इज 1/2. So the answer is 1 upon 2. So the it's very simple. Just multiply the, when you are multiplying two fractions, just multiply numerators together and multiply the denominators together. If there is any simplification possible, do it, cancel it and get the answer. Now move towards the next slide. That is product of a fraction. Product of a fraction. So these are mixed number given, whole number given, just multiply it. So 2 whole number 3 upon 5, 1 whole number 1 upon 14, multiply by 28. So first what you will do, you will convert this mixed number into improper fraction. First convert these two fraction into improper fraction by multiplying 5 twos are 10. Then add 3 in. 10 plus 3 is 13. So the conversion of 2 whole 3 upon 5 is 13 upon 5. So first, this is the first step to convert the mixed number into improper fraction. Then multiply by 14. Once the 14 plus 1 is 15 upon 14. Multiply by 28. So first convert this both the mixed fractions into improper fraction, and then these are two fractions and this is multiplied by 28, a whole number. Okay, as I have told you earlier slide, that multiply all numerators together, multiply all denominators together. So 13 into 15 into, this is a whole number, so the whole number can just multiply in the numerator. So 13 into 15 into 28 in the numerator, and in denominator you will just write 5 into 14. You will just write 5 into 14 in the denominator. Now if there is any cancellation possible, do it over here. This is the simple way. Or maybe you can just multiply all the numbers and then you can cancel it. But the simpler way is this. If there is any cancellation possible, do it over here. So 5 and the 5, 5 3 is a 15. Okay. 14 ones are 14, 14 2 is a 28. Now the leftover is, the leftover numbers are 13 into 3 into 2. So if there is any query, write in the chat box. Now this is 5. This is remaining is 1 into 1. Now multiply by this in denominator, we'll get 1. So in answer, we don't write 1 in the denominator. So just multiply the numerators together. 13 into 3 and then into 2. 13, 3 is 39, into 2 is 78. This is the answer of this question. Okay, students, hope you will get the solution. Now, if there is any question answer, write in the chat box, or in meanwhile, note down the home task. Take the screenshot of the home task. Exercise 5.1, page number 83. Question number 3. 5.1, question number 3, you will do it part 6, part 10 and part 12. And then question number 4, you will do it part 5, part 11 and part 14. This is the continuation of exercise 5.1. The previous task is given in the previous class. You will continue this work. Question number 3, part 6, part 10, part 12. And in question number 4, part 5, part 11 and part 14. Also, you will frame 10 MCQs from the chapter and do in your copy. Same as you will practice all the taught topics in your rough copy. All the questions that are shown on the slide, you will practice all the questions or all the topics in your rough copy. This is the practice work is in rough copy, and this work in your fair copy. You will do this home task in your fair copy of the subject. Okay, students, that's it from my side. Thank you and Allah Hafiz.